Welcome to the Kaiser Jamaica Show. My name is Damar.
And I'm Shani.
And today we'll be talking about
the different categories of driver's license. Okay, so to acquire the actual license that you want to operate, whichever motor vehicle or motorcycle on the road, you first have to get a learner. And the learner lasts for what, 1 year?
1 year.
1 year. You have an entire year to learn and you get all the practice on the road before you go on the test to get an actual license.
There are two main categories of the driver's license. You have the motorcycle and you have the motor car or motor vehicle, because car, truck and bus covering that type of person, we call it motor vehicle. So the motor car now, you have a different license that allows you to drive cars, and you know we have the automatic only license. Mostly females that just want a little private license. You go in and say, want a little bit cheaper. You go in, but you don't really have any. You can't really drive anything. You only can sit there with the automatic vehicle, the size. You have a size limit, the weight limit of the vehicle. That's something they normally give you like 4,000, 3,000 kg. 7,000, 5,000, and just like that, the weight, different types of vehicle, they'll classify the driving based on the weight of the vehicle. So like a Polestar would have a different weight from a regular car. So that's how they classify it. And you have another thing on the license, the PPB. So most time persons have to upgrade a regular license include PPB. Sometimes you might have PPB for the car section, but they can't drive the motor truck. As PPP.
Oh.
Motor truck buses are classified as motor trucks. So that kind of cause of confusion sometimes persons with motor truck and don't really know what motor truck is. But motor truck is bus and all of the big units they call motor truck. And to drive like a trailer now with the extension on it, they would have a different addition on the license that state they can drive trailer, different addition under the license.
So, based on the test that you do when you go to the
test,
all of that is
detailed
and
packaged. Yeah, and the back, or by the top. What the size, and you can do, they can always do multiple tests. So, for example, this year when that did an automatic only. Feeling very competent enough, you know, you can go on and say, alright, I'm stepping up, I'm doing a general now, I'm moving from a private license to a general license. And then you do the test now, what they get your general, you still have a weight limit, you have any PPP, and if you want to move up again, you know, you want to go to PPP, you do another test. It's kind of a waste of money still because you have to pay for all of these tests. But sometimes you really have to go to the depot with the vehicle that they want to operate, like a big vehicle, and then do the test with that vehicle to actually get a license to drive that vehicle and let them know that they want PPP on it, or they have open general, like when you drive something like a truck or something, they open general, they don't put any weight on it, so you know, they can drive any vehicles. It's just that they cannot drive the trailer because they have to open the trailer section. And the trailer one is kind of tricky. They have to do special training to really drive the trailer.
You said something about general and open general. What is
that
about?
Open general is basically one that can drive anything. The general, the regular general is like they're governed by the weight. So you would have about 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, 7,000. It would go up by the weight. So open general, no, they don't put any weight on it. They're unlimited now. You can drive any size. Any size vehicle you can drive, and that's how it works.
There are age limits to, because I know you can get the learner 17 and older, but to get the actual
license, there are age limits. Well, I don't know. There is no age limit as it relates to the driver's license itself. They know that they renew a driver's license every 5 years currently. But the only issue I think is that if they reach certain age, like you're up in age, like you reach 70 and you're going up, insurance won't allow you to drive anymore. So they won't want to insure the vehicle with your age on it. But they're going to look at it as a risk, and they don't really want to take on that risk. So insurance is not going to want to do that, and that will kind of disqualify you from driving because they don't have any insurance cover. coverage and all of that. And for the PPV, now persons doing PPV, really they have to be 21 age and older.
So even if you get your license,
before
you were 18 and you want to drive PPV as long as you're 21
and over,
years and older, you can't go and get your PPV on your license.
Mm-hmm. But they can't get it before you reach 21. So it's kind of a thing to really keep out too much young stuff on PPV. But I don't think you really, cut anything, because you have some of the 25-year-old still have to be like an 90-year-old on the road. Thank you for watching.
See you
next time.
Thanks for watching again, guys. If you like that video and you found it informative, please like and subscribe.
And share. Tell them to share.
Share it. Share the video. See you next time.
Bye.